This is the gospel of the Lord. Thanks to you, Jesus Christ. Dear friends in Jesus Christ, today we have the theme for our reflection is Mother Mary is praying for all the people affected with this coronavirus. As we know, last month on August 15th, we have celebrated the Assumption of the Blessed Virgin Mary. On 22nd, the Queenship of the Blessed Mother. In the coming days, on September 8th, we are going to celebrate the birthday of our Blessed Mother. As we reflected earlier, why Mother Mary Assumption was taken place and the Queenship of Mother. After reaching heaven, being there, she has the duty for praying for all the people. Today, as we are going to reflect, let us also reflect about our Blessed Mother, why she has to pray for us. Number one, she is and she was chosen by God from the beginning of the creation, as we read Genesis chapter 3, 15. And also, when the time came for her to be born on earth, it was the plan of God. And according to his plans, she has to fulfill the will of the Lord. As we know, these days we have been frightened or affected with so many disasters that are taking place. When you read the history, we'll come across in 1347 to 51 AD, 4 to 5 years, we saw the Black Death Plague that lasted for 4 to 5 years, affected by fleas and body lice, killing 75 to 200 million people. Those days, as it reports, world population was 443 million. This Black Death killed between 17 to 45% of the world population. And also, the second reason the history gives us is 1855 to 1980, which lasted almost 125 years, caused by infected fleas and body lice, killing 15 million people. Its mortality rate was 90% without any treatments. The third pandemic is between 1877 to 1977, which lasted for 100 years, affected with smallpox pandemic, caused by two smallpox viruses, killing 500 million people. Mortality rate was 35% of the world population. And also, 1918 to 20, which lasted two to three years, the Spanish flu pandemic, caused by the H1N1 influenza A virus, killing 17 to 100 million people. Mortality rate was 3 to 4%. In the present time, in 1981, killing 32 million people, the mortality rate was varied from time to time till today. As we know, this COVID-19, the coronavirus disease 2019, has become one of the greatest pandemics of the world history. As we know, the world cases are more than 2.70 crores. In India, 40 lakhs of people have been affected. The deaths that have taken place in the world, 8.7 lakhs. In India, almost 70,000. As we know, through the history, we have 223 countries, of which 213 countries were or have been affected because of this virus. Why these pandemics or diseases or flus or any floods or earthquakes or famines that are taking place? What is the basic reason for this? As we know, the first reason that we give is we don't have love for the Lord. We are not loving the Lord. As Deuteronomy 6:5 says, love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your mind, with all your strength. We love everything except God Himself. The second reason is we don't love our neighbor. As Jesus said, love your neighbor. As the Ten Commandments also say, love your neighbor. The second reason is we never read, listen, meditate, practice the Word of God. We have less time for the Word of God. According to the book of Prophet Amos, chapter 8, verse 11, where we read, the Sovereign Lord declares, when I will send a famine through the land, not the famine of food or thirst for water, but a famine of hearing the word of the Lord. It's too, my dear friends, we have time for everything, not for the word of God to read, not to hear, or to meditate, or to follow. This could be the basic reason. And the second reason that I give you is, we are not praying. Why we are not praying? We are sleeping like that of Jonah the prophet. In the book of Jonah, chapter 1, 6. As we know the story, I don't want to narrate all the story, but the quote goes like this. The captain of the ship came to Jonah and he was telling him, what are you doing here? Are you still sleeping? Get up, call on your God. Perhaps he will spare us a thought so that we do not perish. When Jonah was sleeping without bothering about the other people, when the ship was sinking, was just sleeping, when the captain shouted at him, he got up and saw the situation. We are also in the same situation. As we know, during this time of pandemic, COVID-19, many have lost their faith in the Lord. Not only we ourselves, but also everywhere it is happening. Even now, we are becoming a dormant church, a sleeping church. Wake up now, like that of Prophet Jonah. Then we will come to know. Sometimes God also tells us like this. Isaiah 65:1, the Lord said, I was ready to answer my people's prayers. I was ready to find me, but they did not even try. We are not at all trying to find God. Then he says, The nation did not pray to me, even though I was always ready to answer, "Here I am, I will help you." The Lord is always ready to answer prayers, and it is we ourselves don't have or find time to pray. Whenever you see these days, most of the people in the world are fans, they have become fans of cell phones. It has become a kind of a passion. Having cell phones, looking into the cell phone, looking or watching so many things except time for prayer. No one has got time for prayer. The second reason that I give you is, when we don't pray, what will happen? When we don't pray to the Lord, what will happen? The first reason, Haggai 1:10. There will be no rains, no crops. The heavens above you withheld the dew, and the earth has withheld its produce. The famines will be taking place when there are no rains. Amos 4:7. The Lord said, "I also withheld the rain from you when there were still 3 months to the harvest. I would send rain on the city and no rain on another city." As we know, those are faithful with the Lord will shower his blessings. If you are not faithful for the Lord or with the Lord, he will never send us a rain. The second reason is, the sin of the mankind is increasing and increasing. As we read this one in the book of Genesis chapter 6 verse 5. The Lord saw that the wickedness of humankind was great in the earth, and every inclination of the thoughts of their hearts only evil continually. We commit sin because of our evil inclinations. The second reason that the Lord tells us is, I will blot out from the earth the human beings I have created. When we don't pray, when we do commit sins, the Lord gets angry sometimes and tells us, I have created this man in my own image and likeness. Now I am annoyed with him, vexed with him. I wanted to destroy him. People together with the animals and creeping things and birds of the air, for I am sorry that I have made them. The Lord feels sorry when we don't pray, when we commit sins. And also, he tells us, like the days of Noah, I will send rains, pandemics, floods, famines, any kind of drought. Why? As we know, Genesis 7:12, the rain fell on the earth for 40 days and 40 nights. Compared to that one, today's situation we take. Almost it has been 6 months. All these 6 months, this COVID disease is taking place. Everywhere, every nook and corner. It doesn't see any rich people or poor people, any caste or any language or anyone in the world. Just it passes on to one after the other. Today, what is the solace? What is a peaceful thought for all these coronavirus people? As I said in my introduction, Mother Mary is praying for us. How? Why she has to pray for us? Today, Mother Mary gives us, being a lady of good health, our Velangini Mata or Arogya Mata, she answers our prayers because she said yes to the will of the Lord when she accepted herself and telling the Lord yes to his will. The second one is, she never questioned the Lord back. She never gave back answers. The third one, she also knows every need and thirst of every one of us being her children. As we know, today's gospel, which portrays her, she helps those who are in need. She was announced by the angel Gabriel when she came to know that her cousin Elizabeth was carrying her, and in her sixth month, she wanted to rush up to her and went to her. And when she greeted her and whatever has happened, Elizabeth was so filled with His Holy Spirit and she was so happy. So also, whenever we hear the good news of the Lord, supposed to be happy, supposed to praise the Lord. As Elizabeth greeted Mother Mary, "Blessed are you among women." Not only that, till today in the world, doesn't mean that only Mother Mary was blessed, but she had the extra blessing from the Lord. Every woman is blessed woman, but she is above all praying for us. And also she is above all praying for every woman who suffers, every man or a human being suffers. Today, being her children, let us ask her to intercede for us. Today, as we know, she never leaves us orphans. Most of the families also will pray this prayer of Memorare. Remember, O most gracious Virgin Mary, that never was it known that anyone who fled to you for protection, implored your help, or sought your intercession was left unaided. No person having faith in the Blessed Mother was never unhappy, because whoever comes to her asking for her intercession, she used to pray for them, pray for us too. And also, whenever Mother Mary was appearing to certain people, she was also asking them to pray. Especially, I want to give you a small example, a little example. In 1917, when the First World War was taking place, she appeared to three children, Lucy, Jacinda, and Francis. She was asking them to pray for the peace of the world. That is a prayer. The third reason that I can give you is John 2:1-11, where we read, she helped in the marriage at Cana. No one asked her to help her, but she would have heard some gossips among the people when she may be passing here and there. She heard that wine was over. Nobody told her. Immediately, she understands the problem at the wedding, went to Lord Jesus and pleaded Him, do something. He said, "Mother, my hour has not yet come." Mother Mary knew the hour of Jesus and went to Him and prayed. She reminded of His hour. That was the hour to do something. Then she said to the disciples and the servants there, "Do what He tells you." Today, this is our prayer. Let us do what our Lord tells us. Number one, let us love the Lord. Let us also love our neighbor. Number two, let us also pray for every problem. Number three, let us listen to the word of God. Read, listen, meditate, and follow. When we follow, and the fourth one is, let us follow the commandments of the Lord so that our life will be fruitful in the coming days. Today, as we are reflecting, Blessed Mother is praying for all the people of this COVID and also those who died in Christ, let us also pray for them, and let us also pray for all the parishes, especially for all the Christians in the world. Some say many Christians are dying. Why your God is not answering? God has got a plan. He cannot just see and leave it. He has to fulfill His will. That is what we have to learn from these readings and also from our reflection. We shall also ask the Blessed Mother to intercede for us, especially for all the people, those affected with the coronavirus. Let us all stand and sing, "Be with us, Mary, along the way." Jesus, thank you, Lord, for listening to us.
No one can live as I am. Journey to life alone. Since we are most loved by your mother, Jesus gave us his soul. Jesus, your loving Son, come with us, Mary, come. When Jesus met with rejection, Mary stood by.